like a jockey says, don't worry about me, baby. My right side settled.
Oh, my. That's terrible. Can I get anybody a glass of wine while I'm up? Andrew, can I top you off?
Oh, I'm okay, thanks. Anymore, we'll be calling you Uber.
Is that how you say that? I always thought it was Uber.
A Uber? No, definitely not.
Well, whatever it's called. What will these crazy millennials think of next? A delivery service for beer?
Yeah, that already exists.
Oh, no, from experience.
Leave her alone, Glenn. She's a grown woman, for goodness sake. Andrew, you are more than welcome to stay in the guest room.
Oh, I wouldn't want to put Chelsea out. I'd crash on the couch if I need to.
Well, don't be silly. You're engaged now. We're not such old farts to think that you don't sleep in the same room. You can share the guest room.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. I have to see it again. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe my baby's getting married. I couldn't have picked a finer young man. Andrew, I'm going to get you another glass of wine. That Syrah you brought is excellent. You got to love a man with good taste in wine, huh, Chels?
Oh, man.
All right, how about a few rounds of bullshit? I think you played with this last time, didn't you, Andrew?
Yes, that's right.
Hey, I have to get the cookies out of the oven. Don't you start without me.
Sure, sure. Well, while we're waiting for our refreshments, I'll tell you what Val said to bitchy gym lady today.
Is that woman still harassing Mom? What's her name again? Debbie something or other?
We don't speak her.
Ah, of course. This is the one I was telling you about.
So, okay, after gym class, bitchy gym lady comes up to your mom and gives her the stink eye. You know the one I'm talking about.
Still? What the hell? I thought she'd be over that grudge already. Mom never meant to steal her precious yoga mat. For God's sakes, she gave it back when she realized what happened. Evil woman.
I guess it's true what they say. Hell hath no fury.
So she comes up to your mom. She's just glaring daggers, right? She looks down at her yoga mat. She looks at me and says, I'm glad my husband doesn't come to yoga, or I'd worry my husband might go missing too. Oh. And then just pushes past that.
You aren't talking about me, are you, Glenn? Don't tell them that story. They'll think I'm horrible.
Oh, Mrs. Taylor. Valerie, you don't have to worry. We never think you're horrible.
At least not until we hear the rest of the story. So what did Mom do?
Okay, I can't listen to this. Just for that, no cookies for you, dear husband.
I'll take three, please. Oh, and a glass of milk. So, what did the lady do after that?
So, she drops her gym bag, she comes up to Val, and she just looks at her, and pushes past Val, and you know, your mom would never yell at anybody.
No, of course not.
I don't know what it was. Maybe it was because she accused Val of stealing husbands, or maybe she was just defending me. I don't know, but Valerie just snapped.
Seriously?
She drops her gym bag and yoga mat on the floor, walks up to her and says, excuse me, bitch?
She did not. Mom would never call anyone a bitch.
Okay, so I added that part, but she just said, excuse me, if you have a problem with me, tell me. I'm tired of skirting around you twice a week and listening to your snide little comments. Have a problem? Tell me. If not, get off my case. Either way, shit or get off the pot, lady.
Oh, damn! Did she really say shit or get off the pot?
I don't know that I've ever heard Valerie swear. Sorry for the bullshit game, that is.
She did. God, I'm so proud.
Well, good for her. So what did the gym lady say?
Nothing. She just stared at Val, her mouth hanging open, and left. I don't think she's going to be pushing around Valerie Taylor anymore.
Okay, are you done now?
You mean, am I done telling the glorious story of your bravery as you stood up against the evil witch? Yeah, for the moment, yes. Chocolate chip.
I'm proud of you for finally sticking up for yourself, Mom.
Hey.
I just mean, it's about damn time you start sticking up for yourself. We know you're a thick-ass woman. The rest of the world should know too.
I don't know about all that. Are these my cards? I guess if you really want to see how kick-ass I am, let's see who's going to win. Bullshit. Two aces.
We'll see about that. Two twos.
Two twos? Like a little ballerina, Dad. Bullshit.
What? One of my own daughters thinks I'm full of bullshit? Come on, they're only a tiny pile of cards here. What would you gain by making me take them?
Our parents taught us it is about the principle, not the consequences of the lie.
Oh, man. You see there? That's what you get for teaching them upright. They'll come back and stick it to their parents.
Yeah. 1, 3.
2 fours.
4 fives.
Bullshit!
What? Questioning your future mother-in-law? See for yourself.
She got you there. Three sixes. What do you say to that, little Miss Know-It-All?
I guess all of it's flying this time, Daddy-O. Two sevens. I'll get it. No looking at my cards while I'm gone. I'm talking to you, Dad. Me too, Andrew. Mom, Linda's on the phone for you.
Linda from work or Linda your cousin?
My cousin.
Alright. Excuse me? I'll be right back. I'll be right there. What did she say what the call was about?
No, just thought she needed to talk to you and wouldn't leave a message.
Well, that's weird.
Did Linda say anything about the family reunion next month?
No, she sounded strange. I don't know what it was about.
Well, hopefully we don't have to hear any more stories from your Aunt April about her skeezy teenager boyfriend. What was his name again? Roger or Rick?
It's Ryan, and he's hardly a teenager.
Well, he can't be much older than your sister.
Whatever, he's at least 30, and I think they broke up.
Oh, good. Well, I doubt that'll change the number of drunken stories, though.
True, but hey, at least she's a happy drunk.
Which one is this?
My Aunt April.
Have I met her yet?
She wasn't at Christmas last year, so I don't think so. You'll meet her next month at the family reunion. She's awesome.
Well, let's just hope she behaves this year. The family reunion stresses your mom out enough without having to worry about babysitting her grown-ass sister.
Where's the reunion this year? Stone Park.
Yep, every summer. Gotta love the in-laws.
Dad, be nice. Let's keep planning while we're waiting.
Slow down, Linda. What's going on?
Bullshit!
What? I didn't hear that last part. Can you say that again? What? Are you saying... Oh my God. Are you saying that she... No. No. No.
Well, Chelsea, you little sneak. You know, after all that talk about being above the lie, you see, it's the principle of the whole thing.
But you didn't catch me.
Yeah, you little devil. Just like her father, huh? Are you coming at me from two sides?
Oh my God, no!
Valerie?
Mom, are you okay?
Stay here, Chelsea. I'll check on her. Valerie, what's going on?
Oh God, Claire. She's gone. She's gone.
Who's gone? Talk to me. What happened?
Oh my God. I can't. The last thing I said to her. Oh, I'm such a horrible sister. Oh my God, I can't. The last thing I said to her was not to call me. Oh my God, I can't believe she's dead.
Thank you for inviting us. I know it's been a while. I'm sorry about that. Yeah, you know, this really isn't the best time. I'm just stepping into a meeting. No, it's not a work meeting. I'm just taking a little time off, a sabbatical. I know I need to get back to normal. I'm not ready to. Yes, I get it. Thank you, Linda. Oh, really? Well, that was nice of her.
Just go on. I'll be in a minute.
No, I don't need a referral. Thank you, though. That's right. Just a little time off. Nothing to worry about. We'll try to come up to the cabin for skiing next month. Yes, really. Of course we will. Really. I'm doing okay. Thank you. Merry Christmas to you, too. Okay. Bye, Linda. Oh, God. Stop it. Pull yourself together, Val.
I mean, I had to drive her here today.
She refuses to drive anywhere anymore. She won't even sit in the driver's seat. I worry about everything. You know, I've been having anxiety attacks. I know this isn't something that a person gets over right away, but when does it stop? Well, it's hurting our marriage, you know?
I've told you 100 times, Glenn. I need my space. Stop hassling me. Stop worrying.
Valerie, there you are. I promise we will come to your turn, but let's let Glenn finish his thought. This is a safe space for both of you, as we've said before.
It's just, I'm trying to be supportive. And honestly, it's really fucking hard. I'm sorry, I know you hate when I swear, Val.
So, Valerie, I know you haven't been able to make it to many of our sessions.
I'm sorry, Dr. Schaefer, it's just I've been busy.
I don't mean to make you feel guilty. Although you don't know me as well, just know that I am here for both you and Glenn.
Yes, of course. Thank you.
So, Valerie, how does it make you feel when you hear Glenn saying that he's worried about you?
Tired.
Tired? In what way?
Tired of all of this. Tired of saying the same thing over and over again. I don't know how many times I can tell you the same thing, Glenn. I'm fine. I'm going to be fine.
So when you say fine, are you referring to today and how you feel? Is it that day-to-day life is going fine? Or do you mean that you're done processing this traumatic event?
As I've said before, I'm working through this in my own way. I'm not ready to talk about it here. I don't feel comfortable discussing it with you.
Val, you need to talk to somebody. And obviously, you're not talking about it with me. April is gone.
Stop it. I said I don't want to talk about it.
Look at me.
Valerie, I respect your desire to work within your own time. I will never tell you that time is up or that you need to move on. I would encourage you, though, to talk to me. You need to acknowledge what happened so that you can work through it.
Look at me.
I get it. My sister is dead. But that's not why we're here. We're here to talk about our marriage. We're here to work through Glenn's infidelity.
Jesus Christ, Val, how many fucking times do I have to tell you? I didn't cheat on you!
I've tried to believe you, Glenn, and I've forgiven you. Really, I have. I can't.
You just can't what? Look at me? Let me even touch you anymore? I've told you 1,000 times. Nancy is just a friend. I swear to you on the grave of... I didn't sleep with her! We were just friends! I didn't know who else to talk to about all this. You keep pushing me away! Like you're doing right now. You changed, Val. I love you, and I'm still trying, but until you face it, until you come to terms with what happened that day, I don't know what else to do.
Look at me. Look at me.
I think we need to acknowledge the elephant in the room before we're going to get any further.
Look. Look. Look.
In your own words, Valerie, can you tell me what happened? Can you tell me about your sister?
Look at me!
I got a phone call.
From your niece, Linda, is that right?
Yes. She was in a car accident. She had been drinking and driving again. And I guess they couldn't get to her in time before... And the worst part is that she killed someone. Did you know that? She killed a man just taking his daughter home from a school dance. My sister, April. Now that man's daughter will always live without her daddy. The worst part is that I told her not to call me. I told her not to come crying to me. The next time she got drunk. That's the last thing I said to her. The very last thing. And now... it's like I killed her myself.
Oh, Val, you can't blame yourself. You don't need to
feel
like...
Don't, Glenn. Don't tell me how I'm supposed to feel.
Thank you for sharing that, Valerie. You've been very brave today. The path to healing is not an easy one, but you can be proud of yourself for taking this first step.
Look, can you see?
I see you. And I hate you.
My love, I'm here for you.
Mom, I'm worried about you.
Mrs. Taylor, Valerie, I don't know if I can do anything.
How can I help?
I don't know how to help.
We're here for you.
I love you.
I love you so much.
God, go away. I hate you.
Stop pushing Dad away. He's trying to help.
Talk to the counselor. Talk to
me. You can talk to me.
Please, stop beating yourself up.
Aunt April wouldn't have wanted you to keep holding onto this. There's nothing you could have done.
What could you have done?
What can you do?
There's nothing you could do. It's not your fault.
It's not your fault.
It's not your fault.
Please.
Valerie?
Val.
Mom, please let me help you.
I don't know how to help.
Let me help.
Let me in.
Please.
Val, I can't keep going through the motions. I need you to meet me in the middle.
We never see you anymore, Mom. I want to share important things with you, my wedding, but... I'm afraid. I feel like when I see you, you're somewhere else. You're gone.
I don't know if you realize how much this is hurting your family. And Chelsea, I see it affecting her day by day.
Your family misses you, Valerie. They love you.
I miss my mom.
I miss my love. I miss you.
If you ever want to talk, I'm here for you.
I'm here for you.
I'm here for you. I'll never leave you.
I'll never leave you.
I know. I love you, April.
Must go up. Is this an obsession? profession of yours? There's a name for it. Elevator enthusiasts. Are you making elevator videos?
No. Unless you really want me to. Oh,
you don't have my permission to record me.
Got it. I'm Roxy, by the way.
Who cares? I mean, I don't need to know your name to ride with you in an elevator.
For me, it's about the journey, not the ride.
You call riding an elevator a journey?
I call it the way I see it.
And you're dressed so appropriately for it.
Thank you.
However, there are much better journeys that one can take, you know.
You're in charge of your journeys, and I'm in charge of mine. Deal? So, please, introduce yourself and let the journey begin. And your name is?
Emma! Okay, my name is Emma.
That's a good name. No need to be ashamed of it.
I'm not ashamed of it.
Okay, I'm glad. So, let's start the journey, shall we? What floor?
Well, same floor you were headed to.
I'm going nowhere in particular. We've established that. I'm here for the journey.
Doesn't the destination define the journey?
We're holding the elevator. What floor would you like me to press?
I don't care. I just don't care. I'm not an elevator enthusiast, but I'm not going anywhere in particular either. I was just walking around aimlessly and I entered this building. It's a nice looking building. And there was this elevator.
It's an Art Deco building. Among the steel-framed skyscraper buildings with ugly elevators.
I had to leave the restaurant and walk away after. After.
After?
My husband told me that he was leaving me. He took me to a romantic dinner at the Prima Vista restaurant to tell me that. He's in love with another woman. I poured my wine down my throat and I ran out. I couldn't face him any longer. But where do I go from here? Where do I go?
Up. We go up. This is one option. It's a good floor to check out.
What floor is this?
The second floor.
I could have taken the stairs to the second floor.
I asked you what floor you wanted.
I don't like this floor. It smells weird. Pick another one.
It smells like that everywhere. The whole building smells the same.
But why?
It's an old building.
Is that how Art Deco smells? It's weird.
Weird smells are part of the journey. Weird smelling buildings, romantic dinners, good wine, husbands leaving you for other women, aimless walks down unknown streets. Meeting weirdos in the elevator. It all goes.
Goes where?
Just goes. It goes until it stops, and it doesn't go anymore.
Doesn't smell weird in the elevator. When the door is closed, smells just fine.
Bingo. That's why I stay here. I like the anticipation. Once you arrive somewhere, that's it.
And it smells weird.
After a while.
Or immediately.
Yeah.
What are you waiting for? Let's move on. Let the anticipation start again. What floor? Don't ask me that again, please. I always go for the third floor after the second. I like to stop at every floor.
Do it then.
Don't ask me to get out.
Third floor, here we come.
What happened?
The elevator stopped.
Why? Is it broken? Are we stuck in here now?
It's just a temporary glitch. It'll start moving again in no time.
How do you know?
Just guessing.
What if it doesn't? There was this woman in China once. They stopped the elevator and she was left in there. They found her body, or what was left of her, after 5 months.
That's what happens at the end of the journey. It all stops.
Is this it for us?
I would guess no.
You're guessing? You don't know for a fact.
Well, who knows anything for a fact?
The facts matter. Guessing is useless.
In my experience, my guesses have been more useful than what I've known for a fact.
I'm not liking this.
Let's tell each other jokes to pass the time.
Here,
I've got one. Do you know why ghosts ride in elevators?
Did you have to bring up ghosts now?
Because it lifts their spirits.
It's an old joke.
You haven't heard it?
Well,
elevators do lift our spirits, whether we're ghosts or not yet, right?
Oh, you're so, so weird. I can't believe that I'm stuck in an elevator with you. I can't believe that this has happened. He wants to leave me. He wants to be with someone else, a complete stranger. We spent years together, 15 years. He didn't want children so that we can focus on each other because he was so infatuated with me. And now, what now? I find myself stuck. Stuck in an elevator with a strange woman.
You would have preferred a strange man?
Open the door! Open the door! We're stuck in here! Hello? Someone help! Please, we're stuck!
We're not stuck. It's just a temporary glitch to make the journey more interesting.
Bullshit.
It's a healthy way to look at it.
Why don't you do something?
This is all part of my journey, and I'm accepting it for what it is. Besides, you did this.
What do you mean I did it?
You stopped our journey so you can figure out where to go from here.
You really are crazy.
You got us stuck because you don't believe in journeys without destinations. All you have to do is believe in our journey for our journey to continue.
Our journey.
I'm here with you, am I not?
Why?
There's no reason. Just because. You're here just because, and I'm here just because. And if your journey continues, my journey will continue too. Besides, you entered my elevator.
Your elevator!
I was here first. I was first in this elevator, and I was first in this world.
Well, what do you mean you were first in this world?
I'm older than you.
So?
I can teach you a thing or two.
Oh! Well, lucky me, I'll get free lessons while I'm stuck in an elevator.
Come. Get us moving again. Why stop the journey? Because you've run out of destinations. If there's a journey, there will be destinations, believe me.
Getting stuck is not the answer.
If you're stuck too long, you die. Why die while still alive?
Yes!
Off we go again.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Poison. You're killing me. You're killing me.
We're looking at it today, aren't we?
Caffeine. The unknown. Stop! Immediately! You never do anything I say.
Beware of absolutes. They're always untrue. Oh,
you think you're so funny. Oh, no. Donuts? No. No. The carbs? The calories? The white sugar? No! Why do I even bother?
Because I love you. Now settle down.
Oh, I can't settle down. I'm awake. I'm ornery.
Let me eat my breakfast?
No.
Please?
No.
Really?
Pay attention to me.
Can't I just...
No.
Fine.
Oh, I was suffocating in there.
Are you happy?
Is anyone out there?
Not a select few.
Then why are you bringing another being into the world? It's crowded already. Crowded and unhappy.
Well, I want to be a mother. I want to have a child. I want to be someone's everything.
It's overrated, you know.
Unconditional love? Maybe.
Who's the father?
It's a secret.
Oh, virgin birth.
Not exactly.
Drop it, lady. Heartburn?
Just get these pains sometimes. Phantom pains? They don't seem connected to anything except...
Except that they're connected to me. Something about me brings you pain.
Well, that's part of any long-term relationship.
Is it?
You're fortunate not to know about these things yet. excited for me.
Oh, face it. She's excited for me, not you.
Can it be for the both of us?
Nope. She already knows you. She's excited to meet me.
Not everyone will be excited for you, you know.
Everyone loves a baby.
There are things in this world that are dark, and dark things don't love babies.
I'm not a dark thing. I'm lovable and surprising. You will love me more than anything else in the world. My well-being will consume you. Right now you're having your belly painted, and embarrassing pictures taken, which you'll regret, and comparing me to the size of a kumquat or a yam. But eventually you'll realize the truth. I'm more important than you. I matter.
I know you do. That's why I'm keeping you.
I can change the world.
I'm certain you will.
Throw that one away. I won't like it.
It's from my sister. I'm keeping it.
You don't have to, you know. Keep me?
Don't talk like that. Of course I'll keep you.
You wouldn't have to. Do you vote?
Sometimes.
Then they might have
changed
the laws. It's insidious what these people do. You might not have a choice.
Well, I had a choice. I made it. Don't be morbid.
I'm not morbid. Just presenting facts. Fact, you haven't posted any ultrasound pictures on your Facebook page.
Those are eerie.
Fact, you haven't named me in the womb.
You don't know that. I could have decided already.
But you haven't. Fact, you're embarrassed by me.
No.
I think you are. I think maybe you hope I won't show up.
After all the worrying and late nights, and my body alarmingly turning into this giant squidgy grapefruit, I don't think I'd be doing this if I didn't think you were going to be the best thing that's ever going to happen to me.
But no pressure.
I think you get your sense of humor from me. All right. What shall we call you? Michael? Max? I like the X. Xavier.
Oh, sounds like something out of a romance novel. How about something hip, like Guy or Crow? not something stupid modern like Bit.ly or Pork, but something, you know, workable.
I'm not calling you Crow.
It was a long shot.
Maybe Zachariah or Zenith.
Zachariah. These kinds of names, they... You think you're special because you're having a baby.
Well, I am.
You're not. That's a lie they tell pregnant women, so they'll be willing to endure unendurable pain and perpetuate the species.
I am special.
Millions of other women.
Listen, I am special and so are you.
Testy, aren't we? Must be all that progesterone coursing through your hemorrhoids.
Why are you so mean to me? Ever since we've connected, you've done nothing but judge and preach and prey upon my weaknesses.
Just call me your inner child.
As your mom, I'm ordering you to be nice and quiet immediately.
Mommy, dearest, I love you.
That's the first thing you said all day that I've believed. Now hush, I'm reading.
Mom?
What?
Mom?
What?
Mom?
What? What do you want?
Nothing.
Good.
Mom?
Not now.
Mom?
Not now.
Mom!
I'm reading.
You don't need to read.
Reading.
Mom!
What?
I think I'll be a genius when I grow up.
Great idea.
And I'll be big and strong, like men are supposed to be.
Super.
And I'll crush all my enemies.
What enemies?
Whatever enemies happen upon me, I'll smite them.
Do you know you'll have enemies?
Everyone does.
Many enemies?
Who can say?
No. Thought maybe you just had a premonition. A vision of yourself in a field, covered in gore.
Oh, I don't want
to birth another Adolf.
Like that.
What does your book say?
It doesn't cover birthing murderers.
Must be a different book. Religious, probably.
You're not going to be a weirdo. I'm from good stock. My mother loved me. Her mother loved her. She was a teacher, you know. I would have been too if I hadn't gotten
knocked up,
distracted. I should have focused more. Out of high school, more on the future, less on boyfriends. I have brains. Soon I'll have you. And then I'll need more direction.
Ouch! Why'd you do that?
You would do if you were in my position.
It's stuffy in here.
Bad lighting.
You should be grateful you're in there at all.
Oh, let the mommy guilt begin.
I shouldn't have said that. It's just that sometimes you hit
the nail on the head.
Nerve.
Let me adjust.
Okay, enough now. Let's see here. This'll be soothing. I know you love folk.
You're joking, right? Dada life, Mom! Seriously!
You must get your taste from your father.
Oh, the secret man! He's super, I'm sure. Well, can't you give me a hint? A clue? Throw the babe a bone, momster!
I'd rather not.
Because you're not married? You're an unwed mother? It still matters, you know. You don't even have a partner.
It won't matter. Because you and I will be enough. And besides, someone else will come along. They always do.
Someone who will want me to?
Of course. You're going to be so sweet and small and perfect. You'll pick flowers and ride bicycles, and you'll always share the teeter-totter.
I might.
You will.
What if I throw rocks at seagulls and hit my mother's Camry windows? What then?
Well, I'll love you just the same.
Liar.
I will. A mother's love is
irreconcilable when reality sets in. I hate it when you do these.
For your own good. You can keep healthy and strong.
Oh, what if I'm weak-willed and feeble-minded? Think of the medical bills, the expenses, the humiliation! You don't really know. I could be anything. Would you still be competitive with the other mothers? Could you still beat them at the motherhood game? Or would my disabilities slow you down? Six! Seven!
Four, five, I'm counting here. Four.
Oh, everyone's counting on you.
Five.
You counted that already. Five, six, pick up sticks! You know, don't you, that you're going to lose your hot bod, and they might not come running?
I've still got a little bounce.
That's what they all say. Your boobs drag on the floor afterward. Only a foot ahead of your butt.
When I can hold you in my arms, it'll be so fulfilling. Smelling of baby lotion, joy.
Oh, dream away, little dreamer. Your next year is going to be filled with shit. Shit and more shit. Mixed with equal parts spin up. Do you know what you're doing?
He does. You want to be here. You do. Breathing the
polluted
good air. Drinking the
slime.
Dirt of life. You'll see. Look. This is proof. No one would be doing this taxing, boring project if it wasn't towards some greater purpose.
Some people just buy new booties.
Maybe not you. Yours will be unique.
You can afford new booties.
Not really. I can't afford anything anymore. So I'm making you booties with my own two hands.
I want new booties. New store-bought booties.
Get what you get.
Store-bought.
Look, I've already bought a breast pump, a snot sucker, a diaper magician, and 27,000 wet wipes. I'm not buying something I can make.
Store-bought, store-bought, store-bought!
Fine. You'd probably take your shoes off and go barefoot like every other kid out there. There's something you should know. I might be a bad mother.
Oh, Mom.
I know you will be.
That.
All moms are bad in their own way. I'm sure you won't beat me or lock me in the basement, but come on. In some way, I'm going to be emotionally scarred for life because of you.
I'm planning to be a great mother.
The greatest mother on earth, huh?
Actually, yeah.
It's not going to happen.
Little twerp. You don't know.
Careless attitude. Unstable life choices. Delusions of self-grandeur. Denial of, well, everything. It all makes sense, Mom. But don't sweat it. We're just not cut out to succeed here.
You make it seem like it's my fault I'm destined to fail. What about skyrocketing prices? Missing community? The lack of paid maternity leave in this country? Feel-good jobs? Men who won't...
Men who won't what?
Forget it.
Tell me, now!
Go to your room.
Make me! Mom! I take it back.
Too bad. Too late.
Please? I'm sorry.
For what?
Whatever you're mad about.
I forgot! Fine. You can stay in there until you remember what you're apologizing for.
Oh, Mom. Please. I'm sorry. Mom.
Well?
I am sorry.
For
making you feel bad.
Be nice.
I will. Can I have a donut?
They're bad for you.
You never let me do anything.
Do you want to go back under?
No!
I can't wait to hold you in my arms.
Gross.
Smell your tiny head. Stroke your tiny feet. Not funny.
You're so easy, Mom.
It won't be easy.
Phantom pain?
Real pain.
I'm sorry, Mom.
We won't have it all. All the perfect family time, all the money in the world. We won't own fruit trees or vacation in Cancun. I won't have time off. You won't get to school on time every morning.
It's okay.
My bread may be moldy. Even if I wanted you to have the moon, you won't have it.
Since you're vulnerable right now, perhaps you'd be willing to tell me about my father?
Not that vulnerable.
Why aren't you with him? How can he even talk about the moon when he isn't here?
He knows nothing of the moon.
Oh, weren't you over the moon for each other? Didn't he promise it to you?
That way.
What kind of mother are you?
A terrible kind.
You never give me anything I want. You're mean and wicked and stupid. And I hate you!
You can't hurt me every time you don't get what you want!
Watch me!
Stop it!
No!
You hurt me.
You say I'm always hurting you. Phantom pain.
I thought about it, you know.
What?
Not having you. I don't know if I'm ready. I don't know if in your lifetime the whole earth will fall apart because of fracking, or if you'll get me headed on a bus in Canada just for living. I don't know if you'll be like your father. I just trust. This motherhood?
I've hurt myself. I hurt myself hurting you.
Are you all right?
I will be.
Well, it's a funny thing about getting older.
The pain smarts more sharply, but dulls more quickly. I'll tell you about him. But it's not what you want
to hear.
Believe.
I'll believe what you tell me.
Will you?
Probably.
Well, he was not tall or thin, or streetwise, or wise talking, or worldly, or memorable in any way.
Well, that can't be right. I'm memorable. I'm wise talking.
I know. And yet, it's true. We were together for a short time. I knew his name and the size of his jeans. I knew his place of work, his occupation, his favorite kind of cheese, and his score on Mario Kart. I knew less about him than I would have liked, but I also knew that I liked him.
Oh, now we're talking.
Until he knew things about me. He knew I didn't like the television on in bed. He knew I played the recorder. He knew my best friend's middle name. And eventually, he knew...
Yes?
That I was afraid of him. I didn't want you to know until you were older, until you could understand exactly what I was saying, but I don't think I can hide my fear.
You're confused. This isn't the right story.
That's why you haven't heard of Daddy's voice in there. That's why we're here. The two of us. Alone. That's why it has to be enough.
But... when I'm older?
No.
He might change. You don't know.
I'm sorry. It wasn't safe. It isn't still. But it will be.
There's no such thing as safe.
Safer, then. I will protect you.
No. No, I don't believe you. I don't...
We're gonna be all right. I'll know exactly which way to go. Eventually. Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Mom's gonna buy you a mockingbird.
Haka.
If that mockingbird don't sing, Mom's gonna buy you a diamond.
Lend me your hand and we'll call the ball. your heart and I'll just let you fall. Lend me your eyes, I can change what you see. But your soul you must keep.
Good breeze here, too. Biodegradable. Well, what do you think? Hothouse, desert of a county with a view and a breeze. And I dug this hole. Rock and clay and more rock or nothing. I hear nothing. I feel nothing. Silent treatment now? What do I have to do?
Ah! Cindy! Where the hell are you? What the hell, Cindy?
Wait, just wait,
okay? I nearly killed myself getting down that deer path. Here, take this. My arms are falling off. Mom wasn't a mountain climber, you know.
I wasn't a mountain climber.
Oh, take that out. Wait to get here.
She's not coming here.
Portia says she is.
I didn't do it for her, I did it for Mom. Where is Portia?
She drove herself.
Why? That makes no sense.
I called her this morning. She said she wanted to drive. And I said I wanted to drive. She said she wanted to drive.
Why do you two always have to fight?
I am just tired of her always calling the shots. I wanted to drive, so I took my own car.
Great.
What?
Now we'll have to deal with her in a bad mood.
I'm not dealing with it. You deal with it. Maybe she calms down on the drive. You have dirt?
There wasn't much.
Yes, I can see that. That's why I asked about the dirt. We can't just fill it with rocks.
Why not?
Because... Fine. Fill it with rocks and then mix up the...
That's what I was thinking.
I guess that'll work. How long did it take?
About an hour and a half. There was a ton of granite.
Clearly. What possessed you to pick this spot?
What possessed you to pick this spot?
It has a view. And a breeze. And it's not someplace strangers will find.
Honestly, Sid, not even Mom would-
Stop!
Sorry. I would have helped.
There's a baby at home. I needed to do it myself.
You need to do it yourself. How are they?
Matthew is screaming night and day. I think he gets it all from me.
You were a perfect baby.
I think he just feels my stress. Julie is freaked. Keeps calling the doc every 10 minutes. Matthew won't latch on, so she thinks there's something wrong with her, which translates to she's a bad mother, which translates to she's not a real woman, which translates to existential crisis and the inevitable unrelenting dark night of the soul. I had to get out. It's a madhouse. 2 hours. In the car, without the radio even. worked wonders until I had to scale Half Dome to get here.
Eat.
Got anything else? Granola bars. Scotch?
I brought sandwiches for after. I thought
I'll have mine now.
Sure. Okay.
It's tuna. I thought.
Are you crazy?
It's in a cooler under the tree.
Oh. Okay.
You guys always assume I'm going to do something stupid.
Look at the place you picked!
Asshole!
Space cadet!
Jerk!
Doofus!
Uncle.
Okay. Alright. Tuna?
Okay.
It's important.
Surprisingly good.
Walnut mustard.
Yeah. Where is she?
In the backpack?
You should take her out. Let her see the view.
Hey, Mom.
Hey, Mom. Give me the envelope. I'll put it with the other stuff.
She's such a sexist.
You want the job? Here, I'll sign it over to you. It's a shit job. You really hate someone, make them your executive. No better way to say, screw you, Kimasabi.
She meant to be an honor.
She didn't know it was such a pain in the ass. I think she thought she was giving you a compliment.
I know. What's for dessert?
How about I'll go to the Dairy Queen for soft ice cream?
She'd like that.
Dairy Queen, vanilla cone, child size,
140 calories.
Mary fucking mother of God! Jesus, fuck! Fuck! Cindy! Where the fucking fuck are you? In the holy mother fucking hell! Ow! Jesus fucking Christ! Oh yeah. We're over here!
I can do that?
Fine, just back off and let me walk.
Why the hell are you in a skirt? There's poison oak all over here.
Shut the fuck up, okay? It's a burial.
It's Middletown!
Shut up right now or there will be a little brown box with your fucking name on it. The holy hell are you thinking?
It has a view.
Big whoop.
And a breeze.
Is this it?
Uh-huh.
I need some water.
There's some cold in the cooler, I'll get it.
Thanks.
And I brought saltines.
Thanks. I might steal those for the ride home. You don't miss a whole box on the way here.
Julie says that you should.
You know, don't want to hear what your perfect wife did during her perfect pregnancy with her perfect figure, okay?
Coca-Cola syrup.
Seriously?
She said it really helped.
Where did she get it?
That pharmacy on Sutter. You know, the one that looks like it's from 1945.
Really?
Old-fashioned remedy.
I don't know. Thanks.
Sure.
So how's the baby?
Screaming.
Sorry to hear that.
Not as much as I am.
Please, God, don't give me a colicky baby. So, let's get this done. So what's the plan?
Put me in. Fill the hole.
Then mix up the concrete and put the stone in there.
Nana's gonna go nuts when she sees that.
Nana is not invited if she's gonna make a big deal about it.
It's her daughter.
It's what Mom wanted.
She didn't tell me and Dennis.
She told me, okay? Think I dreamed this up all by myself? She said, bury me in Middletown.
With that plaque.
Madonna and child.
I know. You said so over and over and over. We get it. She shared things with you that she didn't share with us.
Aren't you special? Not special. I'm just trying to do what she wanted.
And did she say, and find a spot in bumfuck nowhere so my 85-year-old mother will break a hip trying to get here?
She might have.
Oh,
sitting in an inflatable boat, not scaling down rock faces.
Tough shit for Nana then.
You don't have to deal with her, I do.
And I'm sure you will. Can we get to the matter at hand?
Fine. Sure.
I thought maybe everyone would like a moment alone with her.
I already had 2 weeks.
When?
The last 2 weeks.
I didn't know that.
You didn't ask.
How come I didn't get 2 weeks?
You didn't ask.
She was sitting in the kitchen. You could have taken her at any time.
Typical. You two...
Oh, yes. The great sibling conspiracy strikes again.
I told you.
Bullshit!
I am sure I told you. About the guy that came to the door?
What guy? What are you talking about, Cindy? You never told me about any guy.
Yes, I did. You didn't
stop
listening.
You never listen.
What for?
What?
The guy who came to the door. What did he come for?
I don't know. I don't remember. It was to pick up a check for something.
Are you writing down the expenses?
I am.
Okay. So this guy comes to the door.
He's standing in the front hall. Dennis is upstairs. As I'm going to get the check in the kitchen, the guy Dennis screams down, mind if I borrow Mom? I need to talk with her. So I go into the kitchen, get Mom and the check. Dennis comes downstairs. The guy is confused. I hand him a check. Here's your check. Turn to Dennis, and here's your mother.
It was classic.
Poor guy.
It was funny. Never mind. You wanted to read something?
Portia, do you want time alone with Mom before we plant her?
What the fuck for? So I can hear her criticize me for having a fatherless child?
She'd be proud of you.
What are you smoking?
Oh, she would. I know.
Did you tell her?
I didn't.
I should throw you off of there right now! Fuck, Sid! I told you not to tell her!
She said good for her! A husband is only a glorified sperm donor anyway!
She said that?
After Dad, you know, you were the exception, though. Mr. Golden Child.
You're not lying.
I meant to tell you after the baby was born.
Maybe engrave it on a baby spoon or something?
No. I'm fine. It's just the hormones.
I'm glad you didn't wait. It makes sense now.
What does?
I've been feeling her around me. But instead of her being angry, which is what I expected when she got to the other side and found out I was pregnant, all the vibes have seemed loving. I woke up this morning and I felt her in the room with me. I felt her hug me.
I felt her. When I was holding Matthew yesterday, I swear she was there. I could smell her perfume.
Baby puke number 5?
You know, that rose smell.
Rose water.
Thanks, Sydney.
Sure.
I have a request.
What?
I want to open the box.
Are you joking?
No, I want to see what she looks like.
Absolutely not.
Why not?
Because it's disgusting.
It's just ashes.
You go ahead if you want, but I'm not doing it.
Sid?
No. What if her spirit's still in that box?
Then she materializes and gives us 3 wishes.
I was thinking more like Pandora's box.
I don't think Mom could ever bring about death and destruction. She was all about her kids.
You are weird, Sid. People scatter ashes all the time. It's not like there's anything in there.
Exactly my point. So?
Sure, okay, just... Can we keep her contained? I don't want to do the scattering ashes thing. I want her in the box so that we can move her if we need to, or... I don't know, just don't spill her.
I only want to see.
You've had her for 2 weeks.
I thought... I just want to... I brought a screwdriver.
Where are the saltines, Sid? They're in the backpack. Okay.
Alright. This is elegant.
A plastic bag. You get a plastic bag with a twist tie for $500.
Looks like kibbles and bits.
Shit, is that her index finger? Tell me that is not her index finger.
It is not her index finger. Maybe it's her middle one. Of course not.
You know.
Logic. The body is incinerated to a temperature of 1800 degrees. If you see something that looks like a finger, it's probably a thigh bone burned to a stub.
I thought it was supposed to be ash.
Yeah, well, maybe they did a shit job.
Don't!
Why not?
Because I said! I want her all in there.
Don't be stupid.
I'm not being stupid.
You think they sucked every speck of her off the furnace floor?
Oh, Dennis, please.
I'm serious, don't!
What are you gonna do? Beat me up?
If I have to.
It doesn't matter.
It does to me. Dennis, back off!
If I wanted a vial of her, you wouldn't let me?
It's not what we agreed. All of her stays there.
You're being an idiot.
And you're being an asshole. Close it up.
Just do what she wants, Dennis.
I just wanted to feel it. Maybe taste it.
No.
Okay, come on. Maybe I'll just touch it with a finger.
No, I said no!
Oh. What is wrong with you?
Just leave her alone. Put her back in the fucking box and bury her.
Why are you calling the shots? She's one third my mother.
That is no one's mother. It's a pile of ash and bone. She looks like a breakfast cereal.
I'm leaving. Just a big joke to you guys.
Sydney, just relax.
No! I'm not going to relax or let go or any of that other shit. You want to play with their ashes like the fucking sandbox, go ahead, but I'm not going to stand here and pretend like it's okay with me. You two bury her. You have everything you need.
Sydney Phillips, you stop right there! If you are not going to be here to bury her, then she won't get buried.
Just put her in the fucking ground.
We will. The three of us.
Better if I'm not here.
Why?
Just do it without me, please.
No! You're not going to do it without you!
I'm the reason she's dead!
A massive infection is the reason she's dead, Sid. What'd you do? Stick your hand in her gut and rub staphylococcus all around there?
Shut up, Dennis!
I didn't plan it. You know how she always would tell me we were alike? She was always saying things like you and I are the same, you're just like me. And she was doing that. She was lecturing me. She said,
I know now why I got cancer.
She knew why she had cancer.
It's clear. I held everything in my whole life.
She held everything in her whole life.
I think all those feelings built up and killed me.
She thought the feelings just built up and killed
Don't
her.
Don't you do that, Sydney. I worry because
and I looked at her. The tube coming out of her nose, with the green goo pumping from her stomach, and how bloated and unrecognizable she was, and I just screamed, no, 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 I am not like you because I am gay! I don't want to die at 57.
Oh my God, Sid, you finally told her.
You picked a hell of a time!
I know, I'm sorry, it just came out. Just looked at me. And her face started to change from love to confusion to realization to anger and finally to disgust. And then she started to throw up, but she couldn't because of the GI tube, and then alarms were going off, and the nurses ran in and
you didn't kill her. She was already dying.
What did she say?
I didn't go back in.
The nurse came out, said she was okay, resting. I went home. And that was the night she went into the coma.
I'm sure she would have told you she loves you.
I made her vomit.
She loves you.
Oh, yeah? And how come she visits you and not me? Why do you know she's there when you're holding Matthew and you feel her loving vibes hug you?
I feel nothing.
Nothing.
I sat with her and talked about where she wanted to be buried. I was holding her hand when she died. I dug her grave. Nothing for me. Not a visit in a dream. Not a smell. A symbol. A feeling. Nothing. I get nothing. I don't have a wife and a baby. Or a fetus. Or an anything. I only had Mom.
Maya Maxima Clausum.
Just calm down. It's going to be okay. Remember when I cracked up the Volkswagen and Dennis set the shed on fire? She forgave us.
I don't want forgiveness, Portia. I want acceptance.
Mom would love us even if one of us was a serial killer.
Portia, comparing being gay to being a serial killer? Really?
Fuck.
You know what I mean?
I mean, it doesn't matter what we do or if she agrees with it. She still loves us. It's gonna be okay for me.
Let's get this done.
Together? You wanted to read something.
Forget it!
No, let's do this the way you want it.
I don't feel like it anymore. I'll be quiet now.
Sayonara, mamacita. Catch you on the flip side.
Thanks for saying that about the baby. I hope you'll drop in from time to time to see her grow up. Bye, Mom. I don't know how I'll make it without you. I really don't. If she was here right now, she'd say, you three are the best thing I have to show for my life.
He who binds to himself a joy doth the winged life destroy. But he who kisses the joy as it flies lives in eternity's sunrise. Goodbye, Mom.
It's beautiful.
Like.
Did you bring sandwiches?
Dennis ate his already.
Did he eat mine?
Here's his safe.
I'm starving. Just pile the rocks in.
Thank you.
was 12. At Pine Tops, Sunday, there was this remarkable girl in our cabin. She had an aura about her and beautiful hair. Her family was from Sausalito. She asked if she could wash my feet. She brought in a bowl of warm water and set it on the floor where I sat on my bunk. She placed each foot slowly in the water. She pulled a bar of soap from her trunk. It smelled of roses. She washed my feet with patience and sureness, as though she'd done this her whole life, as though she was born to wash feet. Then she placed one and then the other on a towel and kneaded them dry. It felt wonderful, sensual, and exciting. I've never felt that way before. I looked down at her, and she looked up at me. Butterflies everywhere in my body. I wanted to be naked with her. And her beauty. Then the feelings came about. I touched the crucifix around my throat and put my shoes on.
I smell roses.